Hello, my lovelies. So, someone or something did not want you to see this video. This is a very specific message for someone who is, oh, I'm getting tingly in my solar plexus in my heart. Wow, this is releasing something, a big release. Holy Spirit wants me to tell you that there's a big release coming in your life. If you've been feeling frustrated lately, if you just had like, you had like a bunch of tower moments and you feel like you're getting back on your feet, and then a couple smaller tower moments keep happening. Ooh, my nose is itching, my ear is itching. That's confirmation. Well, oh my, yeah, my nose is itching. Wow, I'm getting all these activations. Okay. Ooh. I took some time off from doing readings because I did a whole bunch of them, and then I tried to upload them and I was having all kinds of problems, and like technical problems, and I realized now it was the whole Mercury retrograde thing. And now that I'm out of it, I've been like not posting them because I just feel, I don't know, I just, so, the self-criticism. And I realized that's from the devil, that is not from God, self-criticism. Whatever I say, whatever I do in any of these videos, I'm acting as a child of the, of God, of the child, like I'm acting as a channel. I was trying to say channel and child came out. I'm acting as a channel to, no matter what I say or do, the angels and your ancestors and guides will give you the message that you need to hear. So, about this recent tower moment that you just had, you're trying to figure out why this is going on. You're like, what? A good thing about tower moments is it clears the way for something. And at least for myself, I notice when I get into self-pity or when I don't do things that I want to do for myself, tower moments happen. It's like my spirit team forcing me to get out of my comfort zone and go for the thing that I want. So this last tower moment, and I'm working with Angel Gabriel right now to help me get this message out, is leading to your Ace of Cups. I know it's hard to understand sometimes that the tower, if you hadn't gone, had this little tower moment just now, you wouldn't have opened up the flow of energy for the Ace of Cups to come in. And I asked some clarification of what the Ace of Cups meant, who this could possibly be. It's someone who's acting in a Knight of Wands energy, and they were King of Swords energy for a while. They have a lot of passion for you, but they're very immature. And we're leading with their wand, if you know what I mean. And then they were in the King of Swords energy. They were overthinking things, but now they have clarity. They were overthinking for a while. Now they have clarity and making a clear-cut decision. And I asked what this clear-cut decision was, and I got, this is so cool. Oh God. Praise God. I got wedding rings and soulmates. Wedding rings, it says union, wedding, married, soul connection, eternal love, everlasting promise. And this is from the Island Time Wellness deck. And then soulmates, we've got soul connection, partnership, agreement, self, soul contract. So that tower moment that you had, it's okay. Even though it hurt, it's okay. It cleared the way for you to pursue. I'm really getting the, I'm really getting vibes of the twin flame journey. Actually, I put this yin yang on today. If you've been doubting, you know what? If you've been doubting your twin flame journey, it's okay, because that happens. It's totally natural. Actually, when you have your doubts, that's what pulls the other person a little bit closer to, not doubting in a really mean way, but it's an energetic exchange, just like with the yin yang. If you're pushed too hard and you're so sure about this, it makes them feel very unsure. But when you start pulling back and looking at other options and doubting it, then the other, it allows flow, it allows the room for them to chase you, or the energy to flow to you. Not really chase, we're not trying to manipulate anything, but that's just how the energy works. So then I asked for an affirmation. I got, today I will persevere. Today I will persevere. Today nothing will worry me. All my problems will pass in time. God, I don't know who needed to hear that, but I feel, it makes me feel so good. Today I will persevere. Today nothing will worry me. All my problems will pass in time. That is so beautiful. And then, so I asked for more about the situation with the, you know, the Knight of Wands, King of Swords, and I got the Snake. So in your situation, you may have thought this person was your twin flame, but the Snake got in. It says, competition, enemy, clever, malicious, look over your shoulder, or the other woman. So this could have been a third party situation, or it could be just somebody who is trying to compete with you. And I got clarification about that with, it was somebody who was King of Pentacles and Queen of Wands. So they looked like they had a lot of money and were stable and were very, very passionate and sexy. And yep, I got confirming that the person said, was ambitious and motivated, that other person. So maybe your person was doubting your connection and they went to, you know, the other woman or a third party because that person seemed ambitious and motivated. They seemed like they got their shit together, all their ducks in a row. But it really wasn't. They realized, the person realized that you are the their soulmate, that you are the one that they need a, you know, wedding rings and all that. And it says, real change starts from inside you. So that's what your person is thinking about. They're trying to change themselves and become ambitious and motivated. And they see you as you, like that phrase, be the change you want to see in the world, as you make your changes in your life and you stay ambitious and motivated and you forgive yourself, you're inspiring your twin flame, or you're inspiring other people around you to do the same. Any final messages for the collective today? Let's see here, any final messages? And advice from the Holy Spirit, from Angel Gabriel, or your angels and ancestor guides for you specifically. Ooh, this is a good one. Let me see. Oh, two came out. Hold on. Ooh, got two for the price of one. Okay. First one is from Ecclesiastes 4:10. So April 10th could be important to you, or you could be 41. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls down and has no one to help them up. Ecclesiastes 4:10. Oh, praise God. I feel that so hard. Because lately I've been feeling really bitter and jaded that I don't, that so many times in my life I've fallen and had nobody to help me up. And I had to just claw my way back. And I'm exhausted from it. And so this is a reminder that, you know, be compassionate of people when you see them not as far along in life, or people that you might label as crazy, people who are differently abled, people like me who are neurospicy. I try to say neurospicy so that I don't want to call myself like autistic or label myself with ADHD or neurodivergent. Because it feels like it's such a negative connotation. But anyway, and I know a lot of people who do have the issues I have have support. So I'm going on a tangent. Anyway, I'm gonna leave that alone. Yeah, pity anyone who doesn't have support, and just be compassionate to people. And I guess if you feel like you haven't been having support, the message here I'm being told is, look up, child. Being here, being on this channel is your support. The comment section is your space to, your sounding board, your safe space to vent or to say how you really feel, the things that you wish you could say to people. Anyway, all is love. Next one is Nehemiah 8:10. Ooh. August 10th could be important to you, or October 8th. On the other one, January 4th could be important, or October 4th. Ooh, Libra. Okay, then he said unto them, go your way, eat the fat and drink the sweet, and send portions unto them for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Neither be you sorry, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Ooh. It's like, go your way, eat the fat, drink the sweet, and send portions unto them. To them for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Enjoy your life. Live your best life. If you've been suffering, if you've been disciplined, and I'm hearing your training season. You were in a training season before, and it's okay to relax and enjoy life. The training will pay off. It's like you graduated from, you know, your a year or two of, you know, spiritual school or whatever, or mental health school. You graduated, and now it's time to celebrate and enjoy life. Now, it doesn't mean go out and party nonstop, but celebrate, have your little summer break or whatever before you jump right back into doing all the hard work and all the hard training. Ooh, my left eye is twitching. That's confirmation for someone out there. Anyway, I love you guys so much. I hope you all have a wonderful, fantabulous day, and I send you nothing but love and light. Namaste. Mwah.